Thank you. They're failing. They're getting their loot and immediately looking to rotate out. So it's not really leaving Puga and Aviv, anyone left nearby. They're having to forcibly create these storm surge situations, and it's not easy to acquire those tags by any means. You miss one shot, that could be the difference between above or below that damage threshold.
That is true, and speaking about big differences, Peterbot and Pollo just got their hands in on that bunker. Let's not forget the bunker will give you access to that modification bench to change your weapons, right? To get yourself nice and comfortable. And now that they have that, they'll likely be looking for the Rift Island to go ahead and take a fight. Meanwhile, 8 Splitzy and Ovation Vico back in the game as healthy as ever when things were almost fading away for a moment there here in game number 5. But they're in first place, they're in the lead, and they're looking pretty situated now.
They're going straight back to home base. Little do they know, though, King Phaser could be a very problematic circumstance, depending on the approach there for Vico and Flixi, but still inside deep the storm. Muzz and Epic Whale. Decent amount of material count, though, but it looks like Muzz is gonna have to lose at least one of these medkits along the way, fully intending to just locate what he can inside the bunker, maybe even make use of that weapon mods bench.
Back on over to the other draw spot, though, with Vico and Flixi here. It's the landing home. Let's see it, though. King and Phaser playing the low ground right now instead of opting for a little bit of a stronger position. So I'm almost calling bait here, but given his stance, all of a sudden, yeah, things switch around really quickly here. King looking for an opportunity, but no. Drop trying to run here. Phaser must have called back off, and it's not working well. Not right now for them. Vico and Flixi still on the pulse here. Phaser barely gets up to that next layer.
Every shot that Vico lands, it's almost like he's directly telling whoever he's up against, scram. But at the same time, where can King and Phaser actually run to? They are trapped. Vico and Flixi, no reckless railways, like the back of their hands. And sure, I'm aware that King and Phaser, they're bound to have good knowledge as well of the POI, but to the same extent as Flixi and Vico, one of the main takeaways that I got from last night listening to Vico in the player room was him saying, nobody plays Reckless Railways right. We are the only ones that understand this POI. And when somebody is that confident in their knowledge, that's a serious threat.
Yeah, you saw he had every angle. He knew where to cut them off, basically within the building, the structure. And they knew better than to push into the railway itself, given all the cover that's there. So happy with the damage. Meanwhile, Clix and Vino, though, on the move here. Again, no strangers to the storm here. We saw them double back after going north to try to find some tags. Now they're looping their way, again, south and then into the new zone. Everything's starting to piece together. Meanwhile, the standings, one of our top 10 teams are down. Just for that update there, Malabuka and Merstache is that team. Look at this, though. Swizzy, Jacko, from a dub into a fight here, landing on Visuals and Braids now. Looking for the big shot, didn't quite get the maximum damage, but still gets to finish off Visuals there. And all that material, they are right back into it.
The most important part as well for Swizzy and Yapko is that time to elimination was so fast. It's not gonna give a real opportunity for, say, somebody like Yuma in the distance to actually have a chance to play catch up, look to third party opportunity, because it appears in that solo situation. And when that's the case, you're always hoping that you can kind of just stumble upon an engagement already taking place, maybe get some shots in that might allow you an opportunity to go for a little bit of siphon materials, knock, elimination, points, placements. It's really what everybody is after right now.
Thomas HD and Queasy, damage numbers looking phenomenal right now. I don't think there's anyone beating them in the game here at this given moment. Moving around, though, this is the Mount Olympus, right? Home of Quanti and Gone. Should very likely be up top somewhere. Look at this. You got Janice here. You have Kramsu. A lot of the Brazilian teams there. Persa and Ed.
A little bit of a giggle, because if the one search base wasn't enough, Truelix and Chicho have evolved yet again into maintaining two separate search bases, even. Meanwhile, Aviv, Buddha, tangled up a little bit here right now with Swizzy, but we've seen Swizzy perform already once today, MDF. In a 1v2, and this time he's still got his duo with them, but most importantly still, Aviv, Buga, they're trying to do what they can to break through some of these builds, but they're just gonna find themselves cut off. They're not able to actually cross the gap just yet because Buga also needed ample opportunity to make sure that he could regenerate his shields off of what heals they have left, but that's gonna be more than enough room for Yapko and Swizzy to just full on disengage.
Buga and Aviv don't chase either. They just let them go, so it's telling. It shows us that they want another one of those end games. They need another one of those end games, and they can't toss it away. It's a chance for them to go ahead and do just that, but they do need more damage, but... much longer do they fall, but... the Rift Island, we already know. They hit the Mog Bench, they're set up, and then straight to the Rift Island every single time here. And now Shari is so low. Storm Surge gonna be giving them a big, big problem here in the coming moments.
The worst part is knowing that it's Peterbot and Poyo. Every time that Reveal Medallion goes off, it's every 50 seconds, by the way. And again, teams are marked, players are marked for 15 seconds after the fact. That is so much information, and in the hands of somebody like Peterbot and Poyo, it can be devastating for the rest of the lobby, but Cherry, he's managed to find an isolation moment, Worthy trying to do what he can, but the storm might take him out as is. Instead, Cherry diverts his attention to another Oshi player, and he is going to find Damo in the mix. A couple of knocks, a couple of eliminations, couldn't have come at a more perfect time.
Look at this, though, the setup from Aviv and Buga after rotating. They find Swizzy again, so Swizzy was knocked, picked up, and then ultimately falls back to the hands of Aviv here. You can see, yes, two eliminations, so... starting to really heat up now. Buga and Aviv come to late half of the tournament. Ooh. Wait a second, though. Storm Surge is active now. Damage is starting to add up here. Even with that elimination there, they will need a single tag. These are the chances, and when you miss them, it does end up catching up to you. Now goes Buga to the surge. The next tag takes down Aviv, and you know it's over.
It's a tough break. Devastating one, potentially, but at the same time, the mental bounce back, the mental fortitude that players like Aviv and Buga are sure to compose themselves with. See how they bounce back in the final match of day one here today. But more importantly still, all these other duos, all these other players that still remain Monster, Scroll, Sky, trying to scale their way down, but crossing bodies of water, knowing that there's teams already set up on elevation, shots just pouring in from multiple directions, and you're still trying to maintain focus for an open opportunity. Scroll can't even take any sort of chance to heal. He knows that if he pauses one moment too long, that's where he'll be taken down. The build count just not where it needs to be. Handful of armored walls remain now for Sky. He's still trying to see if he can get one more shot in. Any sort of a break at this point, but essentially, MDF, it looks like they're about to fall just outside placement point zone.
Yeah, he's got Batman Buga coming right at him as well. Doesn't quite find the chance to find the tag there. Someone else snipes the elimination there too, and all focus starts to aim towards him, but 46 above here, doesn't hold on long, and he just gets melted right out of the game. Meanwhile, Reet and Ritual are down. Rapid and Batman Buga don't survive the rotate, as you saw there, and so much of the immediate competition, our bubble teams are falling. That's gonna make for a very interesting last game of day number one, given how close it's gonna be point-wise. So we're gonna see a lot of changes come that last round, but Vinoin Clicks holding on by a sliver here.
This is too close for comfort, though. Clicks and Vano have practically no space to work with. They've got two separate teams underneath them. Their only saving grace being the fact that Peterbot Poyo nearby, getting those marked indications from that Reveal Medallion, that's going to be enough for them to emphasize focus onto Reason's box. But again, Acorn, Cold, directly underneath where Clicks and Vano are currently at, and they are looking to be in a much more situated position here. This is tough stuff.
But look who's got high ground again. Flixi and Vico take the chance here while everyone's playing passively boxed up. They snipe up a strong spot, and they already have the marker set up for another high ground spot. And you can tell they're playing for wins here. This is all win condition setups. Meanwhile, Vino and Clix struggling here below the surge. Need damage, they need health. And it's a very healthy Vico and Flixi above them, so not an easy duo by any means, but they don't have that information.
Venno knows that they don't really have much of a choice at this point. They've got to jump into just about anyone's box if they want to keep this game five run going strong, because a refresh is a necessity at this point. The material count entirely too low. They need heals as well. And they're not going to find it unless they eliminate somebody else. But overhead, Vico catches a glimpse of Clix. Takes out a huge chunk of his HP, but at the same time, Clix actually does wind up falling, and Venno meets a similar fate. Just no escape from the top end of the leaderboard.
And it's played so smart. Vico and Flixi use those armored walls perfectly to bait them around, and then right when you think they're not interested in fighting, they get at the top on the Venno and Clix there. And, you know, it's just excellent defense, and clearly they're playing so well. It's hard to compete against that, and talking about that, Peterbot and Boyo continue to find eliminations. Take a look at the replay here. While all of that was unfolding, they find threats with the finish there. Now that's three elims, another end game, inching its way towards them now. Almost zone number nine. That they have math to work with. Too many teams are. Not forget Kovacs and Huddy were taking.
Thank you.
10. Okay. On that side, how can they go there? What Fuzzy on big It's Gyros and Sherry, though, who's building up the high base here. There are roughly 16 teams in this area, all with sightlines on Vino and Clix.
And it comes as no surprise, considering that it's the forecast tower that everybody was hoping to potentially get their paws on, but instead, we'll have to sit back and wait to see what happens next here as Clix, Vino, again. They were just prevented from getting optimal positioning to set up for the forecast tower and launch pad plays, and now they've lost that position entirely to the likes of Peter Bonifoyo, and they know it as well. So at this stage, the only option left is for Clix and Vino to convert these two eliminations now on Amo and Resigns.
Yeah, they're starting to push here pretty aggressively. Clix doing a much better job now as he's side by side his teammate Vino. Opponents, Damo on the right. run now. Built out to the side there. Calisto curious to the fact that he owns some of the territory here. That's going to be a small victory for them in the time being. Up and over they go.
This is where they had initially trapped Resigns and Damo. But at the same time, Damo managing to sneak around out back. But it's only because of the fact that Giras, Sherry, they have moved in to the vicinity. And now Venoclix, fully aware of the fact that there is just too many numbers surrounding them. It's too close for comfort. They've got to find another way to escape. And the other thing that could potentially be threatened at this point for Clix and Veno is the vending machine. It's going to be, I don't want to say impossible for them to make their way to those resources, but at the same time, how do you break through all these duos already surrounding you?
Yeah, and again, more points lost as well. It's not just, of course, the game starting to slow down for them. It's the points that they're not accruing. Off in the distance, they're listening to what's happening. On over to other very familiar teams here, XX Ritual, Reet as well, kind of inside the Doom stat, but you have Muds here waiting, almost combed up, slips out the side there. He's very fast, it's not gonna make it easy by any means. Out the wall he goes, but it's a 2v1. What can you do? Reet takes him down without a sweat.
I know it's really interesting to actually see Reet and Ritual clashing this early on with Epic Was. A passing comment that Reet made in the player last night. You know, we missed out on a cash cup, most recent one. Epic Well and Muzz, they were able to get Mysterio uncontested and all the little goodies that he has to offer. And so, have to wonder now, you get a taste of that kind of power, you want to keep going back for it. So, Epic Well and Muzz, that might be a fight that they find themselves caught up in for more than just today.
Yeah, that makes sense too, right? You get that false sense of security, like, oh, cash cup went great. Let's
it was uncontested, right?
Do that again.
You're feeling good. And then Reet and Ritual, though, there to remind them, no, this is our territory. But again, it could be a clash of the Titans for sure.
Well, Chichar and Trulux have continued to show us that they have what it takes to find their way up the standings here. They've really fought their way up the rankings almost unprecedentedly. No one saw it coming here. But when they make it into the end game, they're just an unstoppable force. You don't really know what to expect from them. You'll find ground sometimes on the height. And all of a sudden now, they're just there.
Trulux and Chicho just have a way of essentially, it all seems like they have a very seamless transition from their early to mid to late game, and a big part of the reason for that is that they are just a team that is notorious. They go for the surge phases, they go for the reliable surge tag damage as well. They are just excellent at bottlenecking teams into a certain flow on the map, because wherever they surge phase at, you know it's going to be an optimal position that's going to prevent everyone else from